Right now, we have discussed about the PowerPoint. We have discussed the content of the book, and next day we have to focus on like what. So we know transition. We learn about animation, and I'll give you a big kind of activity that you can do about this PowerPoint. Right before, actually, we have to move to the new lesson, internet and information communication in the internet. So that will be interesting lesson, because we will be learning about internet, their structure and the search intent method. We will be learning about deep net, dark net, and different like URL based accessing and all, like different services of the internet. We will be learning that. And we also create a web page. So we learn how to create web page and how to manage web pages, HTML codes. So that is the next part, right? And also CSS and all. So that is a big lesson, right? Big lesson and also important lesson. And also about internet threats, malware, viruses, and how internet spread viruses, what kind of hacking and negative effects in the internet. We learn about that in next day. So today I will start that. Next day we'll be learning the basics. Okay, before we finish PowerPoint, I just want to give you some tip. So there are websites, if you search, so this is one website, okay? So PowerPoint can be used to create games, something like TikTok. This TikTok is not that TikTok app where the people are dancing. So what is this one?
It's a game.
Right, it's a game. So here, these games are created by using this Dart game, and different games are there. These are created by using PowerPoint. Interesting. And you can create like, Minesweeper game. How many of you Minesweeper game?
I have played that, sir.
You know how to play that, right?
Yes, sir.
How?
You have to click at one block, then numbers appear according to that. You have to open blocks without blowing up.
Okay, so try to create a game like that using PowerPoint. So that will be interesting task. I know it's difficult, but try to create something like that. Okay, let me show that. So can you share, Puti? Can anyone share the screen? Let me explain that game, how this is happening. Okay, can you open that? So everyone have this game in their computer. Everyone has this, right? All of you, Minesweeper. Just search Windows and you'll get this game. So this is interesting game, and this will develop your analytical skills. Right? Not just a game, but it is developing your analytical skills. Still it's loading, right? Right, okay. You can see, can you click on one dot? Right here, when you click on one dot, you can see, right? Don't click on some other, right? Don't continue to play. I want to explain this to others, right? When you click on one dot, Pute, so there are numbers appearing. These numbers has a meaning. So this one means around this one, there's a one mine. You can make one vatator, you know, you can go to within ekai, dekai, tunai, hatrai, pai, hai, hatai, atakti. Ekak vatator, go to atakti. Me go to atakti, there are eight. From eight, that one means there's a one mine. I thought me, ek a mine nekak make it, you know, a bomb back metanatino. Emanang a bomb, animare, you know, this is a bomb. Why? All other, this is open, all these are open, means, so surely this one is a bomb. How you can mark that? You can right click on that. Can you right click on that, Penny? This one, the star one is a bomb for sure. If you didn't right click, game over. You said that you know, right? Okay, you have to mark that as a bomb, right? Mark that as a bomb. Okay, now then make a mark karane puthe make ekak mark karane then aay man kotuwa kanne then make kotuwa gam make kotuwe deka wateeta me deka ne thiyen round 2 there are 1 mine is there and there should be 2 mines ne deka wateeta bomba dekak thiyenne me meka mine ekak neme mekat na mekat na this is not and for sure this is also a bomb you have to mark that like that now you found 2 bombs now how many bombs remaining 8 bombs remaining so here you have one and around one so when you find this around one when you square this so this is for sure this is a bomb because around one there's a one bomb ek wateeta bomb ekai so there this is a bomb here also one hari etoka oy widiyata api hoya gattama here also one you can see around one there's a one bomb and it is already marked therefore this is not a bomb you can open that yes that is not a bomb and you can open that is safe to open that you can see that around one there's a one bomb so I think now you know the logic right you can play the game you know the logic right here so around one there's a one bomb so this is safe then this one is safe then right okay likewise so around two there are two bombs around one there are one bombs here also around one there are one bomb for sure this is a bomb now six more right around one there are one bomb here around one there are one bomb for sure this is not a bomb this is not a bomb because we have already one bomb there so likewise you have to keep finding the bombs and keep finding the mines and actually after finding all there are six more mines to find so you can do that okay what is basuru what is this what is this putin no don't download it so it is already there in your computer ke net the basuru aniwaryen thiyennona minesweeper is default right by default it's there right no need to download this separately so isn't it there in your computer I wonder that I don't know the recent versions I have not checked but normally it comes with the computer right and not only that here tic tac toe is a game so that you can create using PowerPoint and VBA right tic tac toe you can create using PowerPoint and VBA this one tic tac toe and here there are some more games Ola created these are all IQ games they are created by using PowerPoint right here this is also IQ game Geopardy that is also IQ game and this is also family PowerPoint game template this is a template actually Wheel of Fortune that is also PowerPoint game So likewise, there are PowerPoint games, and you have to try to create one game, so if possible, so that will be a very good experience to you. You will learn programming, some amount of programming, and also, so you will learn PowerPoint in interesting way. Okay, so that is about it. Now we have discussed the topic, and one more topic remaining, as you said. So that is bugs. Let me finish that because we have time. We can finish that as well. Bugs related to programming. Bugs means, so there's a nice story behind that bug. So let me show an image and start. This is first computer bug. Actually, it's not a bug, it's a moth. Right? It's not a bug, it's a moth here. So this is the moth. How a moth became a bug? That is a problem. The moth can become the bug can become bug can become moth is like a fly, you know, kind of butterfly, you know. How a moth became bug? Actually, earlier days, when you work with computer, if something happened to the computer, as a programmer, you are responsible to actually repair the computer. We are computer program, you know, programmer connect with the software, you know, computer ka kaduna. Then we are a computer ka hada no na putte. You have to actually repair that computer. That is a challenge. So earlier days, programmers were really upset about this, and they have a very few programmers who took this risk. Because the computer size, computer size is like a garage. Not like garage, sorry. It's like a building. The control room is like a garage. It's a very big one. So closer to millions of hand soldered joints. Atim pasa puta million gana. Therefore, people were not interested in programming. But one guy did program, and unfortunately, the computer was broken. He wanted to find out what is the error. He checked every search. Sorry, he checked every switch. And in between a switch, there was something. He suspected it's a bug. He suspected it's a bug. Switch එකක් අතරේ දැන් switch වැහෙනවනේ switch වැහෙන්න එපා වැඩ කරන්න මේ වගේ switch එකක් තියෙනවා මේ switch එක හරියට වැහිලා නැහැ මොකද මේ මැද්ද ඉන්නවා bug කෙනෙක් එයා දැක්කනේ යම් bug කෙනෙක් වගේ තමයි එයා දැක්කලු so but after removing the bug actually he found that it's not actually a bug it's a moth but here the first actual case of bug being found The first actual case of bug being found. So bug means actually error. In today's computer means bug. In today's computers also, bug mean error. That error initially it was physical. Issarame switch athare mona hari hira vela aapu errors sama thibilathi. But nowadays, bugs are the errors in the program. If you code this in errorful way, So program won't run. So it won't run the program. So if you eliminate the bug, so means debug. If you remove the bug, debug, then computer can run smoothly. So that is the story about bug and debug. How bugs are there in the program? How bugs are there in the program? For an example, okay. Here you can see. There are two programs, program with bugs and program without bugs. The first program, you wanted to draw a square, but it came up with this shape. This is not square. So you can see, this is due to some order issue. These are called actually logical bugs, logical errors or semantic, sorry, yes, semantic errors. This is called semantic error, right? Semantic or logic error, which is quite difficult to find. If it is a syntax error, let me show something using the number one programming language, which is Python. If there's an error in syntax or error in code, Okay, let me write small Python code. I'll take a new file and I'll write something like this. I want to print hello world. Text hello world in Python. And let me save this as bug.py. And run this. So this will give an error. So this error says print is not defined. So can you find out the error? Can you tell the error?
You spelled print as
PR. Yes, I misspelled print. Print should be print. So that is finding the bug and debugging. After debugging, if I run this again, you can see it will print hello world. That is okay. That is working. Okay. So that is called syntax error. Syntax error means error in the code. That will be easily discovered. That can be easily discovered. I'm going to write another code. You don't know Python, but don't worry. You can correct this. Okay, see this code. I'll explain this. T dot forward 100 pixels and T dot left 90 degrees. Okay, let me run this. Actually, I wanted square. I want to draw a square and I'm running this. And you can see in my screen, it is drawing something like this. So this is called logic error, semantic error. What has happened? Can you fix this error? Can you tell?
You don't know Python. Add range for?
How you found that?
I guessed it, sir.
Yes. So the thing is, this is saying tree, no? For I in range tree, no? Tree means 1, 2, 3 sides. But I have to tell 4 if I need all 4 sides. So then run this and that will give you a square. Right, that is the debugging phase. So basically, syntax errors can be easily identifiable. Semantic errors or the logic errors cannot be easily identified. Here, actually, they explain about a semantic or the logic error. So no, you don't need actually to know what is syntax, what is semantic. You don't have the difference between syntax and semantic error. Basically, think about errors. The error full status are called bugs. Errors are called bugs. So when you correct that error, that is called debug. Errors are bugs. When you correct that, that is called debug. Actually, if you use the correct logic, so let's say find range 50 and I'm turning like 127. So this is quite difficult to detect whether it's buggy or not buggy. And you can see what is the shape that is drawing. It's drawing a nice shape like star, right? Likewise, the coding is important. Actually, so these codes, this code is kind of errorless code. So just drawing kind of star in the screen. You can practice this with programming languages, but this is Python. Actually, you can write that in your mobile phone even using PyDroid, or you can install Python in your computer. This is world's number one language nowadays. These days, the world's number one language is Python. Right, in our courses also, we are teaching this. In Teen Programmer course, we are teaching Python. Right, if you are interested, you can learn. Okay, with that, I'll stop for today. Right, I'll stop for today because we have already discussed the lesson, finished the lesson, also discussed about the bug thing. And now we have officially finished chapter, main chapters. Now the remaining is a large chapter. We have to discuss that as well. That is internet. I'll start that next day. Then good night. Stay safe. See you all next week.
Good night, sir. Have a nice day, sir.
Good night, sir.